Okay, today we are talking about the number 10. Do you know what? Coincidentally, it happens to be the 10th anniversary of this channel. So Numberphile has been going for 10 years. We're so proud of it. And we thought it'd be nice to return to the original location of our very first video, which was about the number 11. And we came here to Nottingham Forest Football Ground and we sat in row 11, seat 11.
We've just come in through entrance 11. We walk this way up here to row 11. And I'm gonna sit right here in seat number 11.
And today we're going to talk about the number 10 sat in row 10, seat 10. To tell you what's special about the number 10, I'm going to introduce you to something called friendly numbers, which sounds nice, doesn't it? Friendly numbers, not to be confused with amicable numbers, which we have talked about before, a classic Numberphile video. This is different, although it starts off in the same way, because it's going to be about the factors of a number. And we're going to add up those factors together. So let's do an example. Let's do the number 12, 1 is always a factor. And I'm going to add these together. So 2 is a factor of 12, 3, 4, 6, and 12 itself. And if I add these together, I get 28. And what I'm interested in is how big is that number compared with the original number, which was 12. So if I'm comparing them, one thing I could do is I could divide that sum by its original number. That's what I'm going to do. So 28 was the sum of factors. Let's just divide that by the original number 12. 28 divided by 12, I could probably cancel that down. I think that's going to be 7 over 3. That's 2.333 going on forever. So if I'm comparing the sizes, I'm saying that the sum of the factors is over twice the original number. Now, this number will have a friend if there is another number that has the same index. We call this the index of the number. So let me give you an example of a friend for 12, which is 234. So the factors for 234, it's gonna be a little bit more difficult for me. 1, always true. 2, yeah, it's even. 3, 6, 9, plus 13, 18, and 26. Plus 39, 78, 117, 234, the original number. Okay, big sum, what does that equal? 546. But if I look at the index, which is that sum, 546 divided by the original number, 234, we get, well, a fraction that will cancel down, it will be 7/3. Again, it is the same index as 12. They are friends. Oh, friends. And if there's another number that had the same index, they would be friends as well. They'd form a little club together. Isn't that nice? A little team. This might start to sound a little familiar because it's very much like perfect numbers. And that's another classic Numberphile video.
So we're going to talk about the number 8128.
And perfect numbers was the same idea. You took all the factors of the number and you added them together. Let's have a look at 6. What are the factors of 6? I'm gonna add them together, so 1 plus 2 plus 3, and I'm gonna add 6 itself. Historically, they didn't used to include 6 itself, and if I add up all those other numbers, you get the original number back. What I'm gonna do today is add all the factors together, including the original number, and I'm going to get 12. I get a number that is twice the original number, and that's what a perfect number is. It has an index of 2. So it's the exact same idea as friendly numbers, but friendly numbers don't have to have an index of 2. I've done before tri-perfect numbers. And that's when, if you add up all the factors, it's 3 times the original number. So friendly numbers, it's the same idea, but it doesn't have to be an integer. So there are currently 51 known perfect numbers. We think there's infinitely many of them, although we haven't actually proven that, but we found 51 of them, which, by the way, is 4 more than we knew of a decade ago when Numberphile started.
Here are my questions. Do all numbers have a friend? And if the answer to that is yes, do they all have an infinite number of friends?
Very good question. No, not all numbers have a friend. So there are some numbers that are solitary, we call them. So if you don't have a friend, they are called solitary numbers. Sometimes these friends are far apart. Sometimes there's a huge gap between friends. I'll show you an example of that. I did need 2 pieces of paper after.
All right.
So we looked at 24, Let's do an index. I'm going to call it I for index, index of 24. So we're going to add up the factors of 24. What's that going to be? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 12 plus 24. And if I add all that up, it is 60 divided by 24. Or if you wanted to cancel that down, it's 5 halves. So that's the index of 24. If you want to find another number with the same index, 5 halves, 2.5, you have to search quite a lot. So the next number with the same index is 91,963,648. Add up those factors, divide by the original number, has the same index. There's going to be a lot of cancelling down there, but that's how far apart these numbers can be. So solitary numbers. Well, I don't know if you'll be that surprised. The primes are solitary numbers. I guess that kind of makes sense. It does to me. So 5 is a prime. And this is the index of 5. Well, the factors are 5. Well, there aren't many. It's 1 and 5 itself. So it's going to be 1 plus 5 divided by 5, 6 over 5, and that's the index of 5. And there is no other number with that same index. The prime powers are the same problem. That means it's a prime number squared or cubed or something like that. And I'll do an example. 25 is 5 squared. As a prime power. If we look at the factors, what have we got? Well, it's not very much. Again, it's 1, 5, and 25 itself, 31. Over 25, there are no other numbers with the same index. And what I want to point out, why is this true? Notice these index that I did, they don't cancel down. That is actually something that's true in general. So if you look at an index for a number, and if it doesn't cancel down, if it's irreducible, then it is a solitary number. That means that the sum of the factors don't share any factors with the original number. I can sort of tell you why that's true. So what happens is if your number doesn't share any factors with the sum, then it turns out that if you're looking for another number with the same index, that number will have to be a multiple of your original number. The problem with that is if it's a multiple of your original number, it has a larger index, not the same index. And that's why it doesn't exist. So your number is going to be solitary. Unfortunately, that rule I've just told you isn't enough to find all the solitary numbers. In fact, there are solitary numbers that break that rule. 18 is an example of that. We can do the factors, okay? So 1 plus 2 plus 3. Plus 6 plus 9 plus 18, we'll divide by 18 itself. That is 39 over 18, and that does cancel down. I think I'm going to get 13 over 6. So it breaks that rule, but this number is solitary, and that's been proven by hand. So it actually turns out the same kind of excuse as before. If you look at 18, if you do the calculations by hand, it turns out that another number with the same index has to be a multiple of 18. And if it is a multiple of 18, it has a larger index. Therefore, it doesn't exist. 18 is solitary. So now let me show you which numbers are solitary and which ones are friendly. So the friendly numbers I've marked out in blue here, 6 is a perfect number. And we know that means it's friendly. And I've got 12 and 24, 28. These are friendly numbers. They have a partner. They have friends. The solitary numbers I've marked in green. So your primes, prime powers, and numbers that don't share factors with that sum. And I've also marked out some of the special ones. 18, 45, 48, 52, they are solitary, but they're not prime, they're not prime powers, they don't have that special rule, we've worked that out by hand. But there are some numbers we don't know. The rest of these numbers here, which I've marked in yellow, we don't know if they are friendly or solitary. It's going to be hard to work out. It's actually a hard problem, and the smallest one we don't know is 10.
10?
10.
We don't know. We don't know if 10 has friends or not.
So we don't know 10 has friends. We've checked numbers going to the trillions. We haven't found a friend for 10 yet.
Find 10 a friend. What is 10's index?
Well, we can work it out. So let's find a friend for 10. Factors of 10. 1 plus 2 is a factor. 5 plus 10. We're dividing by 10. So what we're going to get, 18 divided by 10, 1.8. We are looking for a friend for 10. It's going to have an index of 1.8, but we haven't found it yet. Maybe 10 is solitary. And what I like about this is that there are still mysteries about such a small, humble number like the number 10. Welcome to our first official video on our new channel called Numberphile 11111.